Namaste. Okay. Yeah. All right,
here we go. I'm Katelyn Mcdonough. I'm the assistant director at the Connley Caves Field School 2019, and I'm a PhD student at Texas A&M with the Center for the Study of the First Americans. Yeah, the Connley Caves site is an incredibly unique archaeological site because it has been occupied intermittently for as much as 13,000 years. And in our earliest record at the end of the Ice Age into the early Holocene, we have repeated occupations to this site. And during those occupations, people had fire pits that are still perfectly intact. They left bones and plants, and they're actually preserved here in the dry caves. That's one of the great things about the high desert in Oregon, is it preserves all these really fragile, delicate remains that you don't get at many archaeological sites. So not only do we have a really old record, we also have an incredibly rich lithic and organic artifact assemblage for that time period. Yeah, we have been working in this cave since 2014 because we go down in small levels every year, taking so many samples. And we finally have gotten to the bottom now in 2019. And so we've been excavating the very oldest component at this site. And it looks like we may have a 13,000-year-old occupation. We can't really say that for sure yet. We're going to be doing a lot of analysis in the fall and the winter and probably the coming years to refine our chronology and understanding. But that is what we have been excavating this year, and it looks like people have been coming here since the end of the Ice Age. So one of the biggest highlights of the 2019 field school season was finding a complete concave base point. And that was extremely exciting because they've been found throughout the Great Basin and even at this site before, but they've never been found in a datable context. And that just means they're usually on the surface or they're somewhere where there is not charcoal nearby that you can directly date. So we don't know what their age is, and we don't know how they relate to other stone tool types in this region. So this is going to allow us to finally figure out the age of concave base points. Okay, so the Connley Caves has such a diverse and extensive lithic stone tool assemblage through time, and we can see how the stone tool forms change through time. And because people were repeatedly visiting the site, we can date those different changes in the stone tools and look at how people's tool types are changing, and also how the food that they ate and their subsistence was changing through time as well. Yeah.